Good morning, one and all. My name is Reverend Patrick Jennings, and welcome to the New True Vine Live broadcast, where the Spirit of the Lord is alive. I'm so happy that you decided to join us on this morning. My prayer is that this word will not only bless you on today, but bless you throughout the week, giving honor and recognition to the angel of this house, our pastor, Pastor Patrick A. Jennings. I thank him publicly for this opportunity to speak on his channel, on his platform. My prayer is that God continues to bless him in an extraordinary and a mighty way.
Yes, Lord.
In the midst of everything that's going on, in the midst of the highs and lows, it's difficult to see and wonder where your help comes from. But no matter what we're going through, no matter what the odds are in front of us, we are able to say that no matter what, we are safe in his arms. I know it may seem scary. I know sometimes we may feel frightened, but we have one thing that we know: we are safe in his arms.
Yes.
Because the Lord is my shepherd, I have everything I need. He lets me rest in a meadow of grass, yeah. And he laid me beside the quiet stream. This is for somebody at home. He restoreth your family to health. Oh, and he helps you do what you're assigned the most. This is what you can tell the devil. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe. That's why I'm safe. Speak from the concept going through it with God.
Amen.
If you recall in the book of Psalms, the 23rd number, it says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. I remember growing up, I had a childhood favorite book of mine entitled Patrick's Dinosaurs. This was an adventure that a young boy took with his older brother as they went to a dinosaur museum. And as they went to the dinosaur museum, they saw all different types of dinosaurs. They saw a triceratops, they saw a megalodon, they saw different varieties of raptors. They even stumbled upon a Tyrannosaurus rex. And no matter what the little boy went through, no matter what he was facing with, no matter how many times he might have felt afraid, he knew that he was with his older brother. My brothers and sisters, I came to let somebody know that no matter what you're going through, you're not going through it by yourself. No matter what you're going through, you're not alone. You're going through it with God. When you're going through it with God, he operates in multiple mysterious ways. One thing that he does is he tells you to cheer up. If you remember in the book of 1 Samuel, the 30th chapter, verse 6, it says, David encouraged himself. David was stuck between a rock and a hard place. David had a lot going on. David had enemies around him. David's people even spoke about stoning him. David couldn't call a timeout. David couldn't phone a friend. David couldn't tell the enemy, hold on, let me go get myself together. David merely encouraged himself. My brothers and sisters, in the midst of this time, now was not the time to have a mental meltdown. Mm-hmm. Now was not the time to be nervous. Now is not the time to throw in the towel. But it is at this very moment that you begin to cheer up. I know it may seem afraid at times. I know you may seem scared. I know that this COVID is more confusing as the days go by and you have less answers and you have more questions. But it's in those moments that God encourages us to cheer up. If you remember in the Gospel of Matthew, the 14th chapter, Jesus is seen walking on the water to his disciples. Mm-hmm. Jesus tells his disciples, cheer up. Now, I don't know why he told him to cheer up, why he told them to cheer up, but if I could use my biblical imagination, I would assume Jesus was telling them to cheer up because even though they were in a storm, it could have been worse. Mm. Even though they were having hardships, it could have been worse. Even though things were tumultuous around them, it could have been worse. Jesus told them to cheer up. If you remember the story of Paul and Silas, they were beaten and then thrown into jail. I love that story because even though it looked bad, it could have always been worse. And you have to get to a point in life, my brothers and sisters, and those of you listening at home, that you have to get somewhere in life where you have to say it could have been worse. Yes, I understand I'm going through it, but it could have been worse. Yes, I understand that COVID is running rampant and racial discrimination and racial violence is constantly plaguing our world, but you have to understand that it could have been worse. It could have been you. It could have been a loved one. I understand that there are some people who are not eating in the midst of this pandemic, but yet you are still able to find food. It could have been worse. Some people are dying from COVID-19, but thanks be to God, this disease has not touched you or your family. It's moments like that where you have to internalize and say, no matter what, I'm going to cheer up. Not only does he tell you to cheer up, but he gives you wise counseling to trump the chaos. If you stay in that book, the 1 Samuel, the 30th chapter, if you go down a couple verses, you see David is having a private and intimate moment with God. David tells God, should I go and pursue them? They took our women, they took our gold, they ravished our cities, they ravished our towns. God, should I go and pursue them? I have to pause briefly to express that when you're going through what you're going through, make sure that you have some type of wise counseling. When you're making a large decision, when you're making a life-altering decision, before a big purchase, it's important that you go before God and you talk to him. Yes. I love how the old folks used to say, have a little talk with Jesus and tell him all about your problems. Mm. Tell somebody who can fix it. Tell somebody who can handle it. Tell somebody who can move the mountains. Tell somebody who can open doors. Tell somebody who's been there before. Tell somebody who's said, if I can do it before, I can do it again. Go tell somebody who can fix it. Due to us acknowledging social distancing, you might have been feeling a little different. You might not have been able to speak to certain people. You may not have been able to interact with certain people. You might have been able to engage with certain people. And that was divine order from God, because instead of them speaking lies, God has been speaking life into you. Mm. Instead of those speaking mess into you, he's been giving you a message. Instead of those who have been speaking sorrow and sadness into your spirit, he's been speaking a brand new song. It's in these moments he's been counseling you and telling you the right things to do, how to move, how to engage, how to live as Christ would like us to live. It's in these moments where you have to be very self-conscious on who you receive information from. You have to be very conscious on who you allow to speak into your spirit. It is very important to have wise counseling in moments such as this. Not only does he tell you to cheer up, he gives you wise counseling, and also he comforts you. Son, behold thy mother. Mother, behold thy son. were words that Jesus uttered to his disciples while he was dying. While he was dying, while he was suffering, while he was enduring pain, he gave the people a word of comfort. Jesus knew that his disciple was going to have a lot of questions when Jesus left. Jesus knew that his disciple would have been all by himself without his wisdom. Jesus' mother knew that she would have endured a lot of sadness after losing her son. Jesus realized that her mother was going to endure a lot of hard times no longer having Jesus here with him. But Jesus put a plan in place that allowed the disciple to find comfort in the mother and the mother finding comfort with the disciple. Right. My brothers and sisters, when you're going throughout life, God always puts a plan in place to comfort you. It's in these sad moments that God is comforting us. It's in these tumultuous times that God is comforting us. It may seem like you're by yourself. It may seem like in the worst moments, God is not there. It may seem like in those tough times, you're looking for God, but God is always there comforting you. If you remember a very common story about a man who was walking on the beach, and there were two sets of footprints. And while there were two sets of footprints, when the hardships came, there was only one set of footprints. And then when the hardship dispersed, there was two footprints. Then when hardships would resurface, there would be one set of footprints. Then when the circumstance and the scary situations would fizzle out, there would only be one set of footprints. One day, the man asked God, "Why is it that when I go through what I'm going through, I only see one set of footprints?" Exactly. God told the man that those aren't your footprints, but those are mine. Mm. In those tough times, God is there comforting you. In those tough times, God is there shielding you. In those tough times, God is there holding you and walking with it and walking you through it. It may seem like you're by yourself, but God is comforting you even in those moments.
Amen.
In the Gospel of John, the 15th chapter, verse 35, it says, "By this we know that we shall know that you are my disciple, that you have love one for another." In this time of pandemic, this is where we need to truly let love be shown in action. We need to allow the love of Jesus to go from heart to heart, from person to person, from breast to breast.
Amen.
It's in these very trying and scary times that we allow the love of Jesus to operate in us. So when you're interacting out in public, let your love flow, still acknowledging social distancing, but allow an elderly person to go in front of you at the grocery store. Pay for somebody else's food at the drive-thru. Be patient while you're in traffic. Be patient while you're interacting with employees. Be patient with those who are working in hazardous conditions. Let your love be shown throughout this time. The Bible says, after you have suffered a while, he will strengthen you. He will establish you. He will settle you. After God has comforted you, it is time for you to now go and comfort somebody else.
Amen.
It's time for you to go and speak life into somebody else's world. It's time for you to speak joy in somebody else's world. When you get on Facebook, instead of posting problems and posting about the pandemonium, speak a prayer into somebody's life. Instead of getting on social media and speaking about the stresses of life and the stresses of everything that's going on, send a song to somebody. If you can't necessarily sing, that's why there's YouTube. Just copy the link and share it, and I'm sure the message will be received all the same. It's in these moments where you have to begin to strengthen up your brother. It's in these moments where you have to begin to strengthen up your sisters. In the midst of all that has been going on in Minneapolis, I know that you have either read or heard of the murder of George Floyd at the hands of the police. And it's in this moment that we send a word of comfort to them. Yes, we send a word of comfort to those who are at home dealing with this situation.
Yes, Lord.
We send a word of comfort to those who are struggling in the midst of this pandemonium.
Yes, Lord.
We send a word to those who are dealing with sad situations.
Mm-hmm.
We send a word
mm-hmm.
to those at home listening. You will be all right, 'cause the Lord, he's with you. Yes, it doesn't matter what you're going through. The Lord, he with you. Yeah, Lord, let the storms come, let the sea billows roll. I know you've been hurting, but those that sow in tears shall reap in joy. Excuse me, but I got happy because I realize that I'm going through, but I'm not going through it by myself. Do I have a witness?
Yes,
if you're listening at home, you need to understand that you're not going through it by yourself. The Lord will, he will work it out. Don't worry about it, and don't stress about it. Let COVID come now. We know that greater is he that's in you, that's in me, than he that's in the world.
Out,
I know, everything will work together for my good. I look at Calvary, and that was Jesus going through. I look at Calvary, and I see my Jesus going through the pain, going through the storm, going through the stress. I see my Jesus being nailed to a cross. I see my Jesus wearing a crown of thorns, pierced in his side. He locked his shoulders and he dropped his head. You know what he did, don't you? He died all day and all night. That wasn't how the story ended. He had to go through it when they put him in the grave. Had to go through it when they put a stone in front of the grave.
Yeah.
He had to go through it as he stayed in the grave. But early.
What did he do?
Early Sunday morning.
Yes, Lord.
He got up with all power.
Yes, Lord.
In his hand.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus had to go through it. And
yes,
if Jesus had to go through it and make it, you can go through it and make it too.
Yes,
my brothers and sisters, we're going to be all right. I know it's hard. I know it's rough. I know even sometimes it may be scary. But we're going to get through this.
Yes, Lord.
Cheer up. God's going to give you sound wisdom. And he's going to strengthen you so that you can comfort others in this time of need. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you may face on tomorrow, the best is yet to come. Be blessed.